quite a surprise. Something, a dream, I guess, which has come true, and quite fortunate to be here tonight with the Remy Nick.
Now, of course, this year being the year of Indigenous people, the AFL have gone out of their way to make it a big celebration on Grand Final Day. You're very proud of your Aboriginal heritage. It must be an extra bonus for you.
Oh, for sure. I didn't know. Someone mentioned tonight that I was the first Aboriginal to win it, and I'm proud of that. I'm proud of my heritage, and I guess it's something to remember as the first Aboriginal.
Well, Gavin, round 16, 17, 18, three votes in each of them, and then two votes in round 19 to take you to 18 in the lead. What was going through your mind at that stage?
Oh, to my surprise, I actually thought I was in for a chance, and with a couple of rounds to go, I thought maybe Kerry and Williams might take it away from me, but as it showed, I guess I come out on top.
Now, your parents back in Adelaide, they must be jumping through the roof at the moment.
Yeah, Mum, she would have shed a few tears, I'd say. The family would be fairly happy, yeah.
Finally, Gavin, last one, a childhood ambition to win a Brownlow medal, was it?
Oh, for sure. Growing up, I always see every year the winner who gets up and wins it, and I always thought to myself, gee, I wouldn't mind being up there one day, so quite fortunate.
Good on you, Gavin. Thanks very much joining us. We've got a lot of media commitments. We appreciate it on Sports Tonight. Yep. Gavin Wanganeen, the winner of the 1993 Brownlow medal. Well, Tim, it's not only been a big day as far as the Essendon Football Club. It's certainly been a beauty for them with Gavin winning the Brownlow today, but at St Kilda, they today named Stan Elves their coach.